Hello, my name is Tiger San, and welcome to Immersive Let's Plays. We're gonna start with Skyrim playthroughs. Maybe later on, I'm going to add some Fallout playthroughs as well. I'm going to create a female barbarian wielding two-handed swords. Badass Nordic. Check. Right, let's start this. Okay, a little bit darker skin tone, please. Not as much muscles. I am using the Pumping Iron mod and Muscular Women mod, which basically allows you to make your female look like this. But I want her to get there. So she's starting as a regular skinny female. Brown hair. I like this hairstyle. Brown eyes. Nice. No lipstick. No way. No lipstick. And the nose is a little bit too big, in my opinion. Oh yes, it's way too big. So let's make it smaller. Jaw has to be Nordic. That looks pretty neat to me. Okay, let's do some war paint. Yes, badass. All right. Sonya the Barbarian. All right. Yes, new beginning, that's the mod that I'm using. And also character creation overhaul, which this is exactly. Warrior Stone, combat class, barbarian, fearsome brutes who inspire fear in the hearts of their enemies, finding little use for heavy armor. They're swift and powerful. Yes, this is what our female is going to be. She looks pretty badass already. I like that. All right, let's start. And
approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall
this
begin.
is the alternative start, I think it's called. So we're gonna
Which city
arrive
did you sail to?
on the boat to Windhelm.
A life filled with opportunity awaits you, traveler.
And before I go to bed, because that's how you start your adventure, you go to sleep there. I have to activate all the mods or configure them. This is the enhanced blood, which looks freaking awesome. I highly recommend that. Blood on weapons. I would say 3 minutes would be enough. That. overall blood life. So including armor. Let's keep it 120 seconds to 2 minutes. Yeah, 3 minutes is gonna be a little bit too much. Seconds. Alright. So, blood, that's it. As is. That's increased spawns of bandits and such. So, yep. I like having a lot of enemies. And that's why I have those add-ons. If I don't fast travel, just travel normally. This makes the traveling very interesting. Because it's not boring like it used to be in vanilla. Like you encounter one bandit, that's it. 200. Here you encounter many bandits, sometimes even 6 bandits at one time, so it's pretty challenging. And I like that a lot. And you raise your skills faster that way. So sorry for this, everybody, but I have to configure those. It has to be done for the game to be enjoyable. Alright, so this is done. And what else? Dance of Death, another very awesome thing. You can increase the frequency the kill moves and decapitation happens. By default is 20%. I like to put it at like 75 or even 80. I'm gonna put it at 80%. Yes, it makes it easier at some point. Sometimes if it procs, it makes it easier because it pretty much kills your opponent before his or her time. So you're not really getting their health all the way down to kill them. Sometimes they those proc when they have below 50% health. But I'm figuring I have so many other add-ons that make the game more challenging. So if I do this, it's going to make it even money, so hell yes. If it's gonna make the game look awesome and feel awesome as your character just cuts through the enemies with all those animated decapitations and kill moves, I enjoy it a lot. Is that all we have to do? I think it is. So pumping iron looks like this. Not much here yet. But as you level up your skills, like one-handed, two-handed, blacksmithing, or archery, it raises your current training by a little bit. So then you have to go to sleep. And as you go to sleep, it transfers from your current training to the body weight. It transfer maximum 1, maximum value of 1 to the body weight. So, and this is pretty slow process. It's immersive, and at about level 25 your character is gonna look like she was training a little bit with heavy weapons. Alright. Activate bed. Let's go to sleep and start our playthrough. Yes, I enjoy this alternate start. Oh, shit. Sorry, everybody. I'm gonna have to go through this. I don't know why is this mod made this way. It's a mod that modifies all the sounds of nature, animals, wind, and taverns and everything. It's awesome, but it requires me to do this. Manually enable each and every single one of them, which is stupid. And you have to do it every time you start a new game, new character. So, yeah, sorry for this, but I'm gonna have to go through it. I'll try to do it as fast as possible. It? I think so. Okay, so what I was about to say, I really like the alternate beginning, because when you go through vanilla start and you go through the Helgen and all the, you encounter a lot of, you kill a lot of Imperials and you encounter a lot of dead Stormcloaks. So you end up having shitloads of stuff, like weapons, armor, and all that stuff. And I find it a little bit too easy on the beginning. So here you start with clothing and that's it. And one sword. And pretty much all the other stuff, like rings, are generated randomly, I think. But that's all. That's all you have in the beginning. Not much. So you have to actually get your shit, which is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to go to the store, to the trader, and try to buy iron grade sword, since this is the barbarian. I arrived from distant lands into Windhelm, and I'm beginning my adventure. Out of my way! Seriously, do I have to stand in front of the entrance to the store?
Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for.
I'm sure as well.
All my goods are legitimate, which is more than I can say for some.
Nothing here is stolen. Nothing at all.
Of course nothing in here is stolen. Only a careless, shameful, idiotic fetcher would do something as stupid as to buy pilfered goods.
Really?
By Azura, I've made a terrible mistake. I bought a gold ring, and Viola Giordano has been missing a ring that looks just like it. It's not that easy. She'd go to the Jarl if she knew I was even remotely involved. You have to get it to her some other way. Look, it's dangerous. But if you sneak the ring into her house, put it in a dresser or something, I will make it worth your while.
Huh. Alright, let's try that. We'll see how good we are in sneaking.
Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
I'm sure it's junk, but that's all I can afford now. Yes, great sword. For a second I was like, holy shit, he doesn't have a great sword. Yes, he does. Awesome. Hide boots, hide bracers, no hide armor. Fuck. That sucks. Balls.
Don't let me. You in her house.
Well, I guess in the beginning,
before we both get caught,
light armor is not giving much protection anyway. In the beginning, at least. So when you start with the alternate beginning, there are some things you need to do. Like, for example, if you want to do the Imperial Trading Company quest, you have to go to the gates and meet this, what's her name, Suvaris Atheron, so that she goes back to her office and you can steal her logbook from her. If you don't do that, you're going to be able to wait in front of the door for weeks if you want to, and she's not going to be there.
You got ways of finding out what you really are.
You're a douchebag. Jesus. You're a douchebag, that's what I know.
The Dark Elves, are you here to bully us and tell us to leave?
No, I'm not.
You come to the wrong city, then. Windhelm's a haven of prejudice and narrow thinking. Unworthy of one such as you.
Maybe so.
Nothing new there. Most of the Nords living in Windhelm don't care much for us. But Walt is the worst.
To be honest with you, I don't care for you much either. I just don't hate you, but I don't care much. Which I'm going to prove to you soon by stealing from you.
Any excuse to despise us.
Yes,
and it isn't just
yes.
The Dark Elves they hate. They make a target of the Argonians as well.
I wonder why don't they hate Khajiits as well, because they look different too.
Until next time.
I guess Khajiits make me think of Jamaican people too much. For some reason they just remind me of the way they talk and their attitude, and the skooma, kind of like weed, makes me think of Jamaican people.
Hi lady, would you like to buy some flowers, please?
Sure, let's see what you have.
I hope you like them.
Yay! Let's get some flowers.
Thanks. Thanks for talking to me.
No problem. These flowers are going to be useful in alchemy, actually, so that's pretty bad.
Something.
She here ready? Not yet. Oh, come on, lady. Let's wait for an hour and see. Yes, she's here now. Oh, wait, I have to go next door first.
Another day, another septum.
Oh my freaking god, is this barn?
I know this place looks horrible.
Yes!
Don't hold it against the company.
Do you even have any customers?
Sad, isn't it? We can't afford to keep the place running since these attacks started. pirates, you see. Raiding all along the coast, from Hammerfell to Vardenfell.
Man.
Only the Shattershields appear safe.
Well, it seems like they may be behind this.
A very powerful family in Windhelm. They run a private shipping operation and would love to have the docks to themselves. Wouldn't surprise me if they were in league with the pirates somehow. Not yet, no.
Let's get you the proof.
Perhaps an intrepid person such as yourself could help with that? They have a dark elf who oversees
operations. I sure can.
Suvaris Atherin. She's meticulous to a fault and keeps a logbook with every transaction she makes. If it were to somehow end up in my hands, I wouldn't argue.
You wouldn't? Why don't you fight back?
Our security forces are limited, and all the mercenaries are tied up in this ridiculous war. We don't even know their base of operations, and attacking single ships won't really solve the problem.
Well, now you have the mighty Nord Barbarian on your payroll without armor yet, but yeah, I'm gonna deal with this for you.
They call themselves the Bloodhawkers. They've been around as long as I can remember, but only recently focused on our ships. A dastardly group, but they're more than simple brigands. Shrewd, clever, not to be trifled with.
Kind of like Ferengi in Star Trek. Not to be trifled with. Yeah.
All right.
Let's do this. I'm gonna try to make it as immersive as possible. I'm gonna sneak there and get her.
One of the same kind.
Oh shit! She noticed me. Fuck it. Think I'm your friend? I may not be your enemy, but I'm not your friend either.
If
here you go.
Logbook, I'll have proof.
I already got it.
Treasure. How did you
here
get
it is.
It? No, never mind. I probably shouldn't know. I see. It looks like Severus has been traveling to Dawnstar to meet with a pirate crew there. Get to Dawnstar and see what you can find out about these rogues. I'd wager they won't be too far from the tavern. Try to find out where their fortress is. The captain, Stig Saltplank, has to know something.
I'm going to do just that. And this is going to be actually really fun. So, I'm trying to figure out where could I get my hide armor? Where is a store nearby? On the way. Actually, I can try the blacksmith. Maybe they have something. All I need is a freaking hide armor. Is it too much to ask? Really? Alright, let's see if the blacksmith has something.
How can Elda hate the Dark Elves when she knows so little about them?
Windhelm is one of the most confusing towns in Skyrim. My opinion, at least. It took me a while to get used to layout and learn where everything is.
Alright.
Well, I put that engraved piece just last month. Working in Windhelm is great. I get to see Ulfric up close. A word of advice. Don't buy...
Everyone says Yorland Greymane is the best...
What have you got for sale? Yes! Let's see. Hide armor. Whoa. Restoration. I don't need this restoration bullshit. Really, you don't have regular hide armor that I could afford? I couldn't afford it either, anyway. I have 30 gold. Shit. Damn it.
Every bit as sharp as what you'll find in Whiterun. I respect Yor, but he has the good fortune to work the Skyforge. Something about the fires. Their steel just holds tighter. If that makes any sense. Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage?
Anything. Fur armor. I can't even buy leather to make myself armor. Steel armor already? Ooh. Ooh. 238 gold. Yeah. Damn it. Oh well.
Whether it's armor you need or a new blade.
Oh well. I can't afford anything yet. We're gonna have to find some other ways to get armor. Maybe kill someone. Oh wait! I reminded myself something. I have an add-on that adds like aftermath of battles, and there's plenty of bodies laying around. And they all have armors, so you can just pick them up and sell them. Which is exactly what I'm going to do. I want that student armor. It's even better than hide armor. Yes, 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 yes. Gold? Holy moly, I may not even have to go there and kill those wolves and shit. Nice! So I got 116 gold already and shitloads of stuff to sell. That looks nice. Except it looks a little bit weird on the dress. Yeah. Let's not wear that just yet. How about this armor? See, this armor is going to work for now. Once my character becomes a little bit bigger, muscle-wise, a little bulkier, this armor is not compatible with the muscular females mod. So when I wear it, it's going to make my character go back to vanilla size. So not every armor, no matter how awesome it looks, it's going to make my character go back to regular size, which I don't want. Or no. Shit, sorry for that. I was just there, so I may as well go there and kill those wolves and get to the other battlefield and pick up all the other armors. Shit, I'm gonna have to wait for my stamina to regenerate a little bit.
I'm on my way to Windhelm to join up with the Stormcloaks. Ulfric has the
good for you. Oh, I don't even have to kill those wolves. They'll be farther away. Give me everything. I want to sell it. Everything. Everything. Ooh. I'm already overcome. Shit. I guess not everything. Let's see, what do I have to lose? Oh, this is the most expensive one. I don't wanna lose this. Let's lose something that's cheaper, but it's also heavy. Imperial. Yeah, I guess Imperial. Shit. A little bit more. Your bracers. Oh man, really? Guess I'm gonna have to come back here. Pick this shit up and sell it. Oh my god, that's a lot of shit. Alright. Let's get back on the horse, so to speak. Yeah, I definitely need more stamina. Stamina is very important for barbarians either way, to be able to perform all the power attacks. And it's actually important that you wear light armor, because when you wear heavy armor, your stamina goes down way faster than when you wear light armor. So it's pretty important that when you're creating the barbarian, you go with light armor. Okay. Let's go back to the blacksmith.
Need some metal hammered?
No, not yet.
To protect yourself or deal some damage?
How about both? Holy shit, 600 something gold. Nice Dawnguard hammer. Imperial bow, I'm going to need. Longbow knots. So that's it. Ah, shit. Don't get out of that menu just yet. I need to buy some shit from you now. Let's hope he still has that armor. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Leather helmet. Yeah. sold this helmet. Oh well.
Whether it's armor you need or a new...
I already have it.
Hey, what you need?
Pretty sweet. Okay, we got the armor. We got the weapon. Actually, let's do one more thing. Let's get Steel Ingot, if he has one.
With my swords in their hands.
And sharpen the sword.
Take a look.
Steel Ingot. Let's just get one. I just need one. Thank you very much.
If you meet anyone in your travels, you need to go to Steel.
You're looking for it. Who knows?
Oh shit, I forgot this is Iron Sword, not Steel. Ugh.
Need something?
Well, Steel Ingot is look. Still going to be useful later on. Iron Ingot. Thank you very much.
Good day.
Good day to you too, good sir. Let's do this. 21. See, I wonder why. I'm guessing this is one of my add-ons. I'm not sure exactly, but when I improve my shit, it goes to superior right away instead of fine, because it's supposed to go to fine, not superior right away. But I'm not going to complain.
Lucky for you, that was just sitting there for the taking.
I'm not going to complain about that. So yeah, see, we get to use our Steel Ingot after all. Let me favorite the bow too.
One day, out of nowhere, she made the most amazing things.
Alright, so now, let's go to Dawnguard. Dawnstar. And encounter this pirate captain Horker.
Hollyfrost farm outside the city. It's honest work.
This is going to be fun. Fist fighting some pirate captain. Alright.
Need a ride?
Yes, sir.
Where do you want to go?
Dawnstar, please.
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
Thank you, good sir.
Whoa, steady.
Let's do this.
Let me know if you want it.
You beast of the worst.
So that's the dude.
Dearie, surely we aren't all that bad.
Stig Salt Plank.
Leave me alone. I brought your mead.
What are you looking at?
Have you heard of a pirate crew called the Bloodharkers?
Ha! captain and a crew of them for, well, on 9 years now. What's it to you?
Lots of gold to be had plundering ships.
Aye, the war keeps the Empire and the locals too busy to worry about us. Haldun calls it our golden age.
You seem to be speaking freely about a lot of your internal stuff, good sir.
Our secret ingredient, if you will. A battle mage of fearsome cunning. Runs the blood horkers. Make sure the battles end right side up.
Where would I go to join up?
Well, I can't just tell that to any skeever that washes up. From the look of you, I'm guessing you're more looking to cause some trouble for the Horkers.
Well, of course, but I'm not going to tell you that. But I'm willing to beat it out of you.
It would be my pleasure.
Would it be?
Come on, let's see what you're made of.
Oh, another
one.
Please, someone do something.
Yeah, mister. You are in for some painful awakening. One more. Good. You got your ass kicked by a lady, sir.
Fought. He's swinging. What are you looking at?
So, where are they?
Haldun won't take my hide for this, but Skyrim's been feeling a bit confining lately. We draw council at Japheth's Folly. The fools in Windhelm won't go near it, which is fine by us.
Jesus, this barmaid is
buff. We and Hammerfell before the other Horkers know who let slip their secret.
Yeah, this is one downside of this mod that I'm using, Muscular Female. It makes every Nord female buff, pretty much. So every character that has the weight slider above zero looks like a bodybuilder, pretty much. Entertaining the guests. I mean the females.
Need something?
Okay, how about we end this episode right here and we continue later. Thank you guys for watching. This was the first episode of Immersive Let's Plays. And see you on the next episode. Bye!